I'm gonna send it too, okay?
Right. Welcome, welcome everyone. This is a beautiful, beautiful day to come together in blackness. I get up every morning and I say it's a good day to wake up in blackness. Welcome everyone, welcome. Greetings, greetings. We have a beautiful agenda put together by our BPP team. We've got some beautiful guests and gifts and special guests, and all y'all are special. So welcome, welcome. It's so good to see all you beautiful faces. Welcome, President Brock. It's good to see you in the BPP space. I think this might be your first time in joining us in the BPP world.
Well, thank you for the invitation. I'm so excited to watch. This is a very exciting moment to stay.
Oh, yes, indeed, indeed. Welcome, welcome. Greetings. Oh, I'm seeing all of these familiar faces. Hey, Queen Cynthia.
We have some alums here also. Hi, Chris. Mm-hmm. Janine Canty.
Mm-hmm.
Adiba.
Dr. D in the house.
Dr. D in the house.
Hey, hey.
Hey.
Hey, Damali.
Hi, Rachel. How you doing, cousin?
Hey, everybody. They really are cousins. Yeah. Just in case you think they're just saying that, they really truly are cousins. Welcome. We're going to get the official agenda started in a couple of more minutes. Has Butterfly joined us yet?
Not yet, but he should be.
He's still struggling with getting it. He needs the link. He said the link hasn't been sent to him yet.
I emailed it.
And AJ, I'll message you his email.
Mm-hmm. And you can also tell him, just email me at my CIIS. It's the auto reply. So anyone who sends an email to adetterville@ciis.edu or BPP, they'll see the auto reply and it has the link. That's the easiest, simplest way. And the link is also in the chat. So if you know someone who wants to be here and they're not here, you can share the link from the chat. And you can also go on your screen. There's a little green, almost looks like a little badge in the upper left-hand corner. That's another place where you can see the link and you can copy it. And it's real easy to share with folks if you know people who you're expecting to see in the space but are not here. Beautiful. So once Butterfly joins us, we'll get started.
Can I say congratulations to Janine Canty for being in the climate psychology certificate program? I read that information through public programs, and very much congratulations. And you're going to be also a presenter on Bioneers. You're really smoking.
Oh, thanks so much. Thank you so much. I'm actually here with my mother.
Oh, beautiful. Hi, mommy.
She's getting a little taste of our community.
Yeah. Well, congratulations. Wow, I haven't been to Bioneers oh gosh, since the mid 2000s, I think maybe 2009, 2007, in the Wayback Machine, yeah.
Well, I'm flying into the Bay on a Thursday afternoon, and I'll be in the area and then in Oakland until Wednesday morning. So anyone who wants to get together, hit me up.
Oh, we're missing each other by a few weeks.
So you all let me know when Butterfly is in.
Email me when you get in Oakland, okay?
We're gonna give him another minute or so, and then we're gonna move forward with the program, and we'll adjust when he does arrive to allow him to make his offering.
He's here.
All right. Hey, Dr. Butterfly, we see you landing on the flower petals. You're coming in. In the cosmic swirl, joining us here in the BPP.
Hey, can you hear me?
Yes, we can.
Excellent.
Beautiful. All right, so I am going to turn my music down and off. I'm gonna stop that. And I begin. I'm looking at my agenda. Latronda has given me my agenda, and so I am going to follow it. As any good person who works with Latronda should do. Follow her lead.
My soul is soon to follow you back to yesterday's moon. It remember me back to yesterday's.
Beautiful.
It will rekindle me, rekindle the spirit into tomorrow. And high on the wind, Sankofa flies again and again. Oh, Sankofa, high in the heavens you soar. My soul is soon to follow you back to yesterday's moon. Will it remember me back to yesterday's sun? It will rekindle me, rekindle the spirit into tomorrow and high on the wind.
And so we welcome you. We welcome you to our opening libation, to our opening prayer, to our opening offering. We open in the spirit of Sankofa, and those of you who are new with us, we pour libation to honor our ancestors, to honor the land, to honor those energies that have brought us forward, to honor that which we are today and that which we leave as a legacy for future generations. So you will hear all of us say the word Ashe, and that means with strength and with power. And it's a word from the, it's a Nigerian term. It's actually a Yoruba word that has traveled with us on the Sankofa bird, which is a word from the Akan people of Ghana. It's a Twi word, Sankofa is. So we are Pan-African in our language and in our energy and in the way in which we move through the world. So I'm going to hold this beautiful plant up, and we will recite the words on the screen, which were composed by our very own Director of Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion, Damali Robinson. And so I will pour, and if someone can begin reading our opening passages.
We welcome the wisdom of the past so that we may open the way for this wisdom in the present moment and in the future. We welcome the wisdom of the universe, the wisdom of all faith traditions in all walks to be with us in this present moment. We call on the names of our ancestors. May the people who came before us walk with us now. May they be with us in this time and space so that we may carry the wisdom forward with us now. Ashe.
Ashe.
Sorry, there we go. In order to be born, you needed two parents. Ashe.
Ashe.
Four grandparents. Ashe.
Ashe. Eight great-grandparents.
Ashe.
Ashe. Ashe.
16 second great-grandparents.
Ashe. Ashe.
32 third great-grandparents.
Ashe. Ashe. Ashe.
64 fourth great-grandparents.
Ashe.
Ashe.
128 fifth great-grandparents.
Ashe. Ashe.
256 sixth great-grandparents.
Ashe. Ashe.
512 seventh great-grandparents.
Ashe. Ashe.
1024 eighth great-grandparents.
Ashe. Ashe.
2048 ninth great-grandparents.
Ashe.
Ashe.
Over the last 400 years, for you to be born today from 12 previous generations, you needed a total sum of 4,094 ancestors.
4,094. Let's call their names. All together, call their names. James and Bernice.
Ray, Carol, Brian,
Steve, McCrary,
Matt,
Redwood,
Hunter,
Barry,
Fern, Pettifer,
Don Winslow,
Nunez, Pedro Nunez,
Herman,
Jay
Taylor,
Baker, Annie Mae Swift, Christine Dunlap, Osiris Bryant,
the Dorothy Height,
Ray Bryant Jr.,
yes,
Learn the Truth.
Area Butler.
Ashe.
Bell Hooks. Ashe.
Ashe.
Angelina Graham.
Ashe.
Think for a moment. How many prayers? How many battles? How many struggles? How much determination? How much happiness? How many love stories? How many expressions of hope for the future did your ancestors have to experience for you to exist in this present moment? Ashe.
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 And because of this, we are able to speak these words.
We call on our ancestors now and the many others and ask them to be with us now. We are because they were, and they remind us to look back.
We call in ancestral wisdom now, that embodied wisdom that is a feeling beyond words. We recognize and know this embodied wisdom as a guide for all of us now.
Ashe.
Ashe.
We listen for ancestral wisdom now, that intuitive wisdom that speaks to us in silence, in whispers, in that inner knowing that guides our every step. Ashe.
We embrace
Sankofa bird now. As it looks back to inform the future, we embrace the sacred bird's wisdom in this moment, and we embrace the wisdom of the Akan people who have gifted us with the idea of Sankofa.
Ashe.
We embrace the wisdom of the ancient teachers and invite us to embrace indigenous spiritual wisdom from across Mother Earth and so many others
the teachings of all infinite and integral paths.
Ashe.
We embrace the wisdom found in lived experiences. Of all of our experiences, our lived experiences, knowing that each of our experiences have brought us here right now.
Ashe. We honor every culture, every identity, every ability, every language, and every age. Ashe.
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 We invite us in this moment to embrace our shared humanity and to take a moment for a deep witnessing of this shared humanity now.
Ashe.
It is from this place that we also welcome our joy and bliss. It is from this place of witnessing that we can dance and celebrate every one of our lived experiences, that we can be with our shared humanity. Ashe.
Ashe.
As we look back across our lifetimes, every moment, and rejoice in knowing it has all been for a reason. It has all been for a divine purpose. Ashe.
Ashe.
We look back. We are thankful for the journey so that we can support ourselves and our community in healing and evolving so that our consciousness may be expanded and lifted now and forevermore. Ashe.
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 And like the Sankofa bird, this look back, this journey with ancestral wisdom, this deep witnessing of one another has prepared us to take this journey in this program together. Now, it has fortified us and made us stronger.
Ashe.
And so we open the way with this word. And if you know this with me, let us anchor it now by saying Ashe.
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 Ashe. Ashe.
And knowing this, it is time for healing. Any negative tendencies that have run through our families for generations can stop with you. You are a transition person, a link between the past and the future, and your own change can affect many, many lives and future generations. Ashe.
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 Ashe. Ashe. Ashe.
Thank you. Thank you. That was beautiful. So as we prepare for this ceremony, before I proceed, I would like to first acknowledge the elders in the room and ask for permission from the elders to proceed.
Go forth, honey.
Thank you. Thank you. And we shall go. So we're going to move into the opening ritual, ancestral libation, which will be offered to us and presented to us by Dr. Butterfly Williams. But before doing that, I'll hand it over to Asabi, and she will move us into the ritual.
Hey, and let me just come on from behind the veil. okay, so I'm just really excited to bring to this space Dr. Butterfly. He has one of the most unique energies, and it is so powerful. And I invite you to release into what he has for us today. Dr. Butterfly.
Thank you so much, Asabi. I'm so blessed and honored to be here with you today. Mentorship is a sacred and holy process that is so desperately needed amongst our people today. connect the ancestors with the people who are living on the earth today, with those who are yet to come, is really one of the most sacred bonds that we hold. It is the ancestral cycle of life, and it is why pouring libations to the ancestors is so important. Dr. D has already given us a very traditional opening libation. And I'm very thankful for that because that gives me a little creative space, you know, to get a little funky with it. So that's what we're gonna do with this libation. But rest assured, this is a sacred and holy process. So let's just take a minute to settle in our chairs, to relax our bodies, to close our eyes. You already know that this is a call and response. I will say something and then you will follow it up with Ashe. May it be so. Omi Tutu, Ona Tutu, Ile Tutu, Tutu Egun. Dear ancestors, we give you thanks and praise for paving the way for us. Ashe.
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 We give you thanks and praise for giving us the strength to go on and doing what we need to do.
Ashe.
Ashe.
Ashe. Thanks and praise for welcoming Angelina Graham into your presence. Ashe.
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 We give you thanks and praise for putting a sister on the Supreme Court, Justice Ketanji Brown Jackson. Ashe.
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 We give you thanks and praise for giving us the Adinkra symbols, a sacred way for us to keep in touch with our heritage. This is still for Ashe.
Ashe.
For Sankofa. Go back and get it. Help us to retrieve our ancient sacred heritage. Ashe.
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 Dear ancestors, thank you for Duafe, the wooden comb. Help us to celebrate the divine feminine.
Ashe.
Ashe.
Help us to celebrate Adinkraheni, king of the Adinkra symbols. Let us celebrate the divine masculine.
Yes.
Ashe.
Akoma. The heart, help us to celebrate the purity of our love for each other.
Ashe.
Ashe.
Thank you for Duina Minam, the ram's horns. Help us to be humble, even when we need to be strong.
Ashe. Ashe. Ashe.
Thank you for Sese Wotsuban, change her attitude. Help us to be flexible when we need to be. Ashe.
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 Thank you for Inmatapo, the pacification knot. Help us to forgive when we need to forgive.
Ashe.
Ashe.
Ashe. Ashe.
Thank you for Aya, the fern. Help us to grow under difficult conditions. Ashe.
Ashe. Ashe.
Thank you for Akwapo Pa, the good farmer. Help us to work hard when we need to.
Yes.
Ashe.
Ashe.
Thank you for Asase Yeduro, the earth has weight. Help us to celebrate Mother Earth.
Ashe.
Help us to celebrate Ananze in Tonton, the spider's web. Help us to tell the stories that we need to tell.
Ashe.
And thank you for Mate Masi. I've kept what I've heard. Help us to listen so that we may receive the gifts that are given to us.
Ashe.
Ashe.
We give you thanks and praise, dear ancestors, for giving us all these modalities of healing, all these ways of being in the world, all these ways of honoring what you have created for us. Ashe.
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 Let us call out the names of all of those who have paved the way for us. We did it before, but you can never thank the ancestors enough. So please call out the names of your dear departed loved ones who keep you strong in your hour of need.
Hi, Ms. Taylor.
Dear ancestors, before we depart, I want to say a special word about the plant that we have chosen as your vessel. It's called a gold dust cotton. It's very popular here in California. It's green with lovely flecks of gold in it. It is a reminder that we are always abundant. We are always wealthy. We are always rich because we have our ancestors. Ashe.
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 That was beautiful. Thank you so much, Dr. Butterfly.
You're welcome.
We're going to continue just for a minute or two, just to sink into our seats, but we're going to continue listening to the drums that we were hearing in the background. We have Brother Kale joining us, and he's with Oakland Hand Drums. There we go. And some of you may not know me, but my name is Latronda Lumpkins, and I am the program assistant with the BPP. And it is a privilege and a pleasure to be of service in helping with the forward movement of this project. On behalf of Dr. D, Dr. Detterfield, the visionary behind this project, Rachel Bryant, another visionary behind the project. She is our director, our chief diversity officer of the Office of Diversity and Inclusion. We have Damali Robinson, the director of Equity, Diversity and Inclusion. We have Deanna Jimenez, who is the director of the Emerging Black Clinicians and the fellowship program there. Cynthia Mitchell, the manager of the alumni relations, and Shamika Smalley, who is my fellow doctoral colleague and also my right hand. She's been my support and helping me plan with the planning activities and the programming for the BPP. I also want to make sure that I recognize our partners, the co-chairs of the Black Student Union, the new Black Student Union, Jen Larsh and Asabi Burris. I said earlier that Shamika was my right hand, and Asabi and Jen has been my legs. So they have been very instrumental in helping me carry this load. Their hands and their legs have been helping me to balance and stabilize and withstand the load. I do not want to forget the Association of Black Psychologists, the national and local chapters. Their input, their support, their the scholars that we have been able to bring for the education, for our programming, made it possible for us to offer enriching and engaging workshops. And the past 2 years, we have been focusing on spiritness. We have been focusing on psychology, epistemology, and personhood, and with an emphasis in our Blackness and our Africanness. So it is with great delight that I welcome you today. I am delighted to have you with us to celebrate as we share in this special moment We close the year of another fabulous academic year of celebrating our Jagnas, of celebrating our Blackity Blackness, of just moving forward to the next level of our quest for knowledge. Our theme this year was Black Thought, Black Liberation, and Black Joy. That was named by Damali, bringing all that energy forth. So moving forward in the agenda, I will ask for Dr. D to share with us the highlights of the year, highlights of not just the year, just from the beginning to where we are now and what is to come in the future. So I'll hand it over to her. And thank you, Kayla.
Thank you, Kayla. I miss you.
Miss you too.
So I am so thrilled to be able to do this once again. Perhaps maybe even my last time being able to do this. We'll see. That's another slide presentation. That
right.
So welcome again, everyone, to the Black Psychology Project at CIIS. We're celebrating our 2021-2022 cohort. And as Latronda mentioned, she and I are the co-managers for the BPP. So we're just going to go down memory lane real quick and take a look at some of our beautiful flyers and presentations that we did throughout the year. Many of these flyers were produced by Damali, and we really appreciate her stepping up and stepping in and helping us out with our graphic design. Damali did a lot of work with the BPP behind the scenes this year. We meet every week for the BPP team, and Damali has been attending those weekly meetings with us. As soon as she came on board, she came on board, and we really, really appreciate that. As I mentioned in the opening invocation, the Sankofa invocation, most of that was composed by Damali. The lyrical mathematics, the ancestral mathematics, that piece was brought to us from Latronda by another sister by the name of Lyrical Zen. And then there were other pieces of it that I composed and brought in. And so that is a beautiful combined work of Sankofa invocation. So I'm going to ask for a visual assist to read just some of the titles of the workshops that you all had an opportunity to experience this year. I'll start with the first one because I know that one because I did it. So what is Black Psychology? That was our very first workshop in the series. And up next was?
Safe Black Spaces.
And it was presented by Christy Hagens. Dr. Christy Hagens is a long-term member of the Association of Black Psychologists. She also runs Safe Black Space here in the Sacramento region, and she is a founding member of the Greater Sacramento ABSI chapter, along with myself and several others. It was a beautiful and dynamic presentation. That was followed by Workshop 3.
Wellness practices to combat transgenerational stress and depression.
Yeah, so you see in that upper right-hand corner, it focused on epigenetics and neuropsychology. So we had two renowned scholars and practitioners in the field of African neuropsychology and epigenetics, Dr. Benson Cook, who is a past president of the Association of Black Psychologists and current historian, and Dr. Tony Jackson, who is the current president of the Bay Area chapter of the Association of Black Psychologists, and he also is the founder of a private practice named Prana Mind. And that workshop was followed by
Affirming Black LGBTQI Identity. And our presenters was one of our very own, Dr. Anthony Butterfly Williams. We had Dr. Amy Robinson, who's also associated with the ABSI, Black Psychologists, Association of Black Psychologists, and Malachi Cote. Malachi has a private practice and also nonprofit youth center working with transgender and LGBTQI youth.
Beautiful. Thank you. Thank you. And, you know, since we didn't have anything else to do in the month of February, we decided, hey, why don't we do our third annual 28 Days of Blackness? And so Latronda, Damali, anyone who wants to speak to the beautiful, it was a lot.
I can just say that this was a lot of goodness. I felt like 28 Days of Blackness was experiential, and it brought in the workshops, guest speakers, but also screenings and,
yes.
You know, like sessions of the inner work that were devoted to people like Bell Hooks and Eartha Kitt who don't get as many of their flowers.
Right. So, yes.
Yeah, this was great. I really enjoyed my first, this was my first time, so I really enjoyed it.
Beautiful. Wonderful. And then we also launched the BPP YouTube channel. So if you go on YouTube and type in BPP at CIIS, you can go and watch the Zoom recordings from all of these workshops. They are available to you on YouTube. For now, they're still under my name until we continue to transfer the materials and everything over to CIIS. But if you go on YouTube, you can either type my name in. You might get some handbag videos if you do that. But type in BPP at CIIS, and you can see the recordings from all of these workshops.
And I just want to add that we had a myriad of scholars, Black scholars, researchers, instructors, professors from CIIS who also facilitated some of these workshops. So please check it out.
And then we continued on with our regular scheduled programming after the 28 Days of Blackness with workshop number 5.
Expressive Arts as a Praxis for Black Wellness. And we had Dr. Danielle Drake, then she was the chair of the CII Expressive Arts Program. Now she's moved into a new position. And I don't wanna be wrong by trying to quote it, but we should be getting word soon.
She is the Dean of Faculty Development and Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion. Ashe.
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 Ashe. Yes.
Ashe.
Powerful. Just a powerful force to be reckoned with. And then we have Ashley Campbell, who is also a doctoral graduate from CIIS, and she taught in the ITP, Integral and Transpersonal Psychology Program. She taught an arts-based research course, and she's a professor in that program. But them two together, this was a powerful workshop.
Yeah.
Boy, oh boy, yeah. It was amazing, yes.
Workshop 6.
I was just absolutely delighted for this workshop, because I just love me some Dr. Myers, Linda James Myers. I just, her optimal conceptual theory and optimal psychology has been what she's been championing and focusing on for over 30 plus years. This was before positive psychology, and she will always counter and confront and correct Western psychology when it comes to our own spiritness and our own our well-being. And then we had Dr. David Mitchell. Dr. David Mitchell is in the house. He's in the room here, but he's also new to CIIS ITP program. And he's teaching a number of interesting classes. One class I was a student in was the color confrontation. And that was some seriousness there. And I just got to say, this was an absolutely phenomenal workshop. We focused on interconnectedness. We focused on Mbutu and communal healing, spirituality and culture, and just optimal well-being and wellness. This was the business.
Yes.
This workshop.
Just a couple of additional bio notes are Dr. Linda James Meyer. She's also a past president of the Association of Black Psychologists and is professor emeritus at The Ohio State University. And then finally, we are here today and as part of our closing ceremony to congratulate all of our BPP at CIIS JECNISHIP cohort participants. And so later in the program, you'll have an opportunity to meet them. And I just wanted to take a moment here. We also offer an opportunity for those of you who have been with us along the journey. If you've attended the majority of the workshop series, please let us know. Email BPP at CIIS and let us know so that we can acknowledge your participation. And so you will also receive a certificate that acknowledges your participation, and it'll have your name on there. And so we would love to email that to you. But let us know if you've been a consistent attendee so that we can acknowledge you as well. And I believe that is my last slide.
All right. So what we wanted to do is take this time, this opportunity, to recognize our supporters, our advocates, our champions in the BPP. These past couple of years have been quite rewarding, and but it's so much work that needs to be done. But doing the whole process of moving this program forward, this project forward, we have had the opportunity to work closely with Rachel Bryant, with Damali Robinson, and with Cynthia Mitchell. And so I'm going to turn this over to Jen Larsh, and she's going to proceed with the honoring of our champions.
Hello, everyone. Thank you so much. I am first in line to honor one of our champions. You've heard her name and probably heard her speak at each of the Black Psychology Project events, and that's because she has been with it from the beginning. So we would like to honor Rachel Bryant. And so just wanted to give a little background. So Rachel D. Bryant serves as the Chief Diversity Officer for the California Institute of Integral Studies, where she earned a master's degree in counseling psychology with an emphasis in community mental health. Her passion and research interests situate her life work and scholarship at the intersection of social justice, education, and psychology. She serves as an adjunct professor in the Master's in Counseling Psychology and Undergraduate Studies programs at CIIS. Rachel also volunteers as a core member of the Healing Clinic Collective in Oakland and as on the board of the directors for the Rafiki Coalition for Health and Wellness here in San Francisco. As a student teacher, Rachel honors the wisdom and intelligence of everyday people, the human body, and the natural world. She confidently believes that all people have the innate wisdom and intelligence to serve as healers and educators in their communities. And she has been integral in the creation and development of not only the BPP, but so many of its alumna and those that came even before that. So thank you so much, Rachel.
Yes, thank you, Rachel. And so this is our offering, our gift to you. I'm going to hold it up. I hope you can see them. These are going to be wrapped up very nicely and packaged and mailed to you, so you'll receive them. But Rachel, let me take the blurriness off. Rachel oftentimes initiate libation. And when she does a piece on water. She talks about the power of water, the coolingness of water, the healing power of water. And so these are the water, African water barriers. So I just wanted you to see these, and they'll be reaching you soon. Thank you so much, Rachel, for all of your support and just diligentness. Thank you.
Thank you, and thank you for the gift. I look forward to receiving it. The gift is really all of you. You make me look good. Thank you.
Wonderful. Next, we're going to have Shamika, who's also a co-chair of the Black Student Union, will be introducing our next champion.
I'm Jamaican for real, y'all. I'm so Jamaican. So Damali Robertson is a champion woman. Damali joined the California Institute of Integral Studies as Assistant Director of Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion after an illustrious 15-year career in progressive nonprofit leadership. She brings what I know and have personally experienced as an unshakable commitment to equity, justice, diversity, inclusion, access, and belonging, along with rich lived experiences to her role at CIIS. From 2008 to 11, she helped pioneer diversity, equity, and inclusion initiatives at the Haas Center for Public Service. Well long before the uprisings of 2020, well long before organizations were ready to invest in this very critical work. More recently, she spent a year leading an in-depth equity project to address the achievement gap between Black students and their peers at a Bay Area high school. Even more recently than that, she co-led DEI initiatives at Root and Rebound while also leading their fundraising and communications efforts, creating campaigns about systemic injustices and disparities built into America's criminal legal system. She grounds her work in anti-racist and anti-oppression practice. Damali is a restorative justice and mindfulness practitioner who approaches everything with a restorative impulse, lots of deep breaths, and compassion. She is the advisor for the Black Student Union and ear and support for us to lean on when we need a calming spirit, a balm to our experience, a quiet yet powerful champion and ally for students, a force to be reckoned with, a light in our experience. Damali, we are grateful for you pouring yourself into the work you do for the CIIS community while employing you to engage self-love. You have touched many people in the community and are an amazing ambassador of the Native Jamaican culture, as well as an exemplar of phrases that we have in Jamaica, such as walk good, out of many one people. And I can tell you that in Jamaica, we'll say shilika with our spirit talawa. The power of your words and prayer is evidence of your dedication to helping other people, and especially to improving the lives of people of African descent. We love you, we bless you, we appreciate you, and we behold the God in you.
Ah, Shay. And see, I didn't know you were doing all that other stuff too, Damali. Like,
yeah, no, you know, it's interesting to hear my bio. I'm like, and sometimes I don't say it all. So thank you for illuminating all of that and, you know, give thanks.
Yes. And then in your free time.
Right.
Then in your free time, you help out. So exactly. This is our gift to you. This beautiful wooden carving. I hope you can see it.
Yes, it's beautiful.
This beautiful wooden carved statue.
Oh, thank you so much.
You will be finding this in your, to you. You will be receiving this and it'll be coming to you very soon.
Thank you.
Yes.
I love working with y'all and I love working on CIIS. So thank y'all.
Oh, that's wonderful. Thank you. So another champion we are honoring today is Cynthia Mitchell, also known as Miss Cynthia or Auntie. Miss Cynthia's background includes over 30 years of progressively responsible positions in education administration. Her earlier experiences in higher education focused on financial aid, student support, career services, and student account collections. Ms. Cynthia has worked for CIIS in various positions for over 21 years. See, I didn't know you were with CIIS that long. For over 21 years, and is now currently the Alumni Relations Manager. Ms. Cynthia has been a champion for BPP, its programming, and forward progress. She has been unswerving in her support to the students, participating in our Black Psychology Project Jegnership Leadership Cohort, and she has attended almost all of the Black Psychology Educational Workshops. Ms. Cynthia, we love you. We thank you for your continued support, and we honor you today with this gift as a token of appreciation in recognition of your advocacy for the BPP and Black students. And this is what we have for you. You can put a candle right here to represent the light that you are in many people's lives.
Oh, thank you. Oh, y'all something else. Thank you.
So this will be coming to you real soon.
Thank you. You know I love y'all.
Yes. And we love you too. So I'm going to turn it over to, I think I could turn it over to Asabi.
Yes.
Okay, good. All right. And let me pull up. I lost my agenda, but anyway, I'll pull it up. But I'll turn it over to you, Asabi. Thank you.
Okay. So hi, everyone. I'm going to introduce our musical guest, one of our musical guests right now. And I feel like I'm looking down at you and I don't like that. So let me try to raise so that I can be eye to eye with you. I'm going to introduce my musical guest, my very good friend and sister from 1914. And I know I don't look like I was born that long ago, but we've been connected since back then. She is a singer. She's a mother. She's a bright light. It brings so much positive energy anywhere she goes. Her name is Kimiko Joy. And y'all, she's got a beautiful voice. So she's going to share it now, and she'll come back on towards the end of the program. Kimiko.
Greetings, everyone. I'm so glad that, you know, even though I feel like I'm just here as a guest, I'm so glad that I got to see from the beginning all the way here, because I am truly in a space of greatness. I'm very honored to have been called to be here and to share my voice with all of you. So thank you for allowing me to share this space.
Thank you.
And I hope you enjoy this song. It's a song that my sister from 1914 requested specifically. And you know, the 1914 thing, that's ancestral. We don't like understand all the science of it, but we just know that it is what it is.
It's real.
And so, yeah, here we are. Here we are. This is a song called I'm just gonna sing the song.
Okay.
I know this song. Get my note. Hang on to the world as it spins around. Just don't let the spin get you down. Things are moving fast. Hold on tight and you will last. Keep your self-respect, your manly pride. Get yourself in gear. Keep your stride. Never mind your fear. Brighter days will soon be here. Take it from me. Someday we'll all be free. Yeah. Take it from me. Someday we'll all be free.
keep on walking tall, hold your head up high, lay your dreams right up to the sky. Sing your favorite song, and you'll keep going, going strong. Take it from me, someday we'll all be free. Yeah. Take it from me, someday we'll all be free.
Yes.
Ashe.
Hey, that was beautiful.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Thank you. Thank you.
Beautiful.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. I'm supposed to be talking now, and I'm kind of swept up in the feeling. That was beautiful, Kamiko.
Thank you.
Love it. Okay. Whew. Just take a deep breath, y'all.
Yes, just breathe. Just breathe it in.
Yes.
Breathe in peace and breathe out love.
Absolutely. Yes. Absolutely. And so now I would like to invite. Oh, there's Tronka. Wait. So I was thinking I could bring Kele up again for a little drum interlude. Kele? Where you at, brother?
I am here.
Hey, okay. Can you play for us for a couple minutes?
Sure, I was going to sing, but now I'm I'm like, why you make me go out to Kamiko? Hi, Kamiko, I love you.
Yo, that feeling is all up in the place. Like, I was like, she couldn't be last.
And I told you before, don't tell me I didn't share the video.
I have a brain, I'm sorry.
Okay. Please, Kele.
You say it with yourself. Oh, yeah, yeah.
yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, Osibisa. The group is called Osibisa.
I say, oh. Beautiful.
I think we're ready to go to the next thing.
So we're going to bring Shamika Smalling up.
Thank you.
And you ready, Shamika? She has something to share with us. A few words. Spoken word, the poet.
So I was supposed to like share a little bio, and that gave me a lot of anxiety for some reason. But then I wrote a little bio thing, so I'm gonna pretend that I'm not me watching.
Okay.
Yeah, because yeah. It says Shamika performed for years under the moniker Shamika Dream. She's a poet, scholar, activist, a community healer who, after years focusing on her own healing and scholarship, is beginning to write and perform her poetry again. So, in all seriousness, I'm really, really happy to be in this space with you all and to be doing this type of work again. And so this, typically when I share, there's hopefully a healing element to the work. And so hopefully there is that. This is a space for you to receive if you're open to receiving energy, Reiki, prayer, cleansing, anything at all. And I'm sharing three pieces in the spirit of Sankofa praxis, a piece related to the past, and it's called The Only Thing I Am Supposed to Do, a piece related to the present that I wrote about us, which is called We Are, and a piece related to the future, which is called Rise Up. And I'll talk about Rise Up a little bit at the end. So, the past, the only thing I'm supposed to do. The idea of this is to think, like, if we're moving, like many of you are moving forward into the next stage of your academic program, professional experience, whatever, and I want you to realize that there's nothing that you're supposed to do with your work, your knowledge, your experience, except be the God that you are. Okay. You know, in the poetry spots when you get quiet and nervous, I'm like, you can do it, girl. You all right. Take your time. So I'm just doing that for myself right now.
Okay, go ahead. You can do it, girl. Take your time. You want us to snap our fingers?
Amen. Take your time, sister.
This is my first virtual performance. It's been that long.
Bring it up.
My last year performance, where I planned it, was in 2018 when I still lived in California. So there's that. So I feel like I am supposed to be here. Feel like this is the moment, and I am standing behind the curtain waiting on my entrance. The sound is intense, my heartbeat, that is. I know you can hear it because you are me. I am the infinite possibilities that wake me up in the morning when I need to create. I am the sound of the piano I hear calling me, the beat on time. I attract myself to it and we mesh. I am stepping onto the stage now. Wait. Breathe. One. Two, three, go. I step onto the stage and declare that I am alive. With every word, I am inspiring another 101 until 1 billion and 1 times infinity overstand the possibilities that exist within me. I know they can all come true as soon as I get rid of the idea of you being separate from me. When I open myself up to the idea that I am already doing that which I want to and let myself go into the never-ending vast horizon maker that is the light, I shall become a new dream, like the phoenix. I am change, happening right now, falling in love with how powerful I am here. I know because in every reflection, I see more greatness. I am the doctor that heals me and the teacher that teaches me and the minister who speaks and the greatness I fear. There, on Front Street, the curtain is behind me and I am free. The lights are on. Where do we go from here? Freedom? I am the woman to be, and let me tell you what I am not supposed to do. I am not supposed to live in the truths that were spoken to me and hurts decades ago. I'm supposed to get over that shit. I am supposed to stand in my greatness. And even that is not what I am supposed to do. I am supposed to stand in the name of freedom and justice for children who understand that the common core can be seen as great. And even that is not what I am supposed to do. I ain't supposed to do shit, because supposed is generally assumed to be the case or believed to be the case, but not necessarily so. And I am necessarily truth at all times, reason in all rhymes. And if you don't get it, it's simply because you think that you are separate from me and fail to realize that not you, but I exist. So get it, the truth that is, there is no darkness in the light. And I don't get myself confused into thinking that my reference to darkness and light when speaking of spirit has anything to do with the color of my skin. So if this piece is supposed to be a thinly veiled narrative on race, then raise your consciousness. Because while that may be generally assumed to be true, that my piece is generally referred to hue, it is not so. It is an invitation to create your own great truth. I planted my seed and they cannot germinate in you. All they can do is inspire you to stop focusing on you and on more. I am God, that is. So we are. The Jagnership cohort. We are our ancestors' wildest dreams. Those who surpass expectations, black like black coffee in the morning, black like ebony, like charcoal, like ash, fertilizing all that is and creating all to be. We are the origin of civilization, the healing of a nation, black like rich soil of the South, black like you and me. We are scholars, see, academics, healers, originators, examples, exemplars, love. We are African, we are indigenous, we are powerful. We may experience oppression, but we are resilient. We may experience downfalls, but we stand tall. We are the manifestation of all that is, all that was, and all that is to be. We are who we need to be. Give yourself a hug, say Madasi, give thanks, Ashe. We are Ashe, we are Ma'at, we are the way. Know this when you don't know where to go or what to do, that you are the way. So you can move forward and rise up. And know that I am not a singer, but when I send it to you, when I say it to you, all I want you to do is just rise up. Don't sit down in the depression. Take yourself high up. You are the breather of your own vibration. I suggest you rise up. Depression is just self-repression. It burns your life up. Stomp down the bad vibes, rise off the ground. I suggest you rise up. Recognize that the one Holy Spirit opened your eyes up. Gave you gifts, sight, smell, taste, speech, and hearing. I suggest you rise up. These gifts not granted lightly, for they are blessed. Open your divine up. We are all spirits, these are just bodies. I suggest you rise up. Activate root sacral and solar plexus, heart opens right up. When you practice the art of forgiveness, clear your throat right off. Only speak truth in your communications, open third eye up. We are all spirits, these are just bodies. I suggest you rise up.
Activate root sacral and solar plexus, hearts opens right up. When you practice the arts of forgiveness, clear your throat right off. Only speak truth in your communications, open third eye. We are all spirits, these are just bodies, last time rise up. Activate root sacral and solar plexus, heart opens right up. When you practice the art of forgiveness, clear your throat right off. Only speak truth in your communications, open third eye up. We are all spirits, these are just bodies. We are all spirits, these are just bodies. We are all spirits, these are just bodies. Crown chakra lights up.
So that's it. Thank y'all very, 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 very much.
Love it, love it. Oh, beautiful. That was beautiful. Wow. I've never seen you perform. That was amazing and so inspirational. Thank you so much for sharing that with us, Shamika.
Yeah,
beautiful. So we're going to move into recognition of milestones and transitions, and this is pertaining to like new births, marriages, deaths, accomplishments, things that we want to highlight among our students, our participants in the JEGNAship BPP JEGNAship cohort, and just in general. If any one of you in the audience has something that you want to share that's a milestone, let's celebrate it together. So I'm going to turn this over back to you, Shamika, and just allow a space for folks to chime in if they have any milestones and transitions that they want to share. And then you can go ahead and highlight the person that we're going to recognize.
Yeah. Okay. So I'm making it so I can see, can you hear me? Oh yeah. I'm making it so I can see the screen. I believe I can see everyone now.
Okay.
So let's first talk transitions, right? And I'll start by honoring my own. So I had a lot of deaths in my family this semester. So I would like to honor my Uncle Colin Barnes, my grandmother Gloria Barnes, my grandfather Derek Smalling. I think those are all the transitions in my family this semester. So we'll honor those. If anybody wants to honor anyone who has transitioned this semester, this year, or at all, you can say simply, you know, say their name, like unmute yourself and say their name while we give a moment. And if the brother is drumming, if you could do a tiny bit of drumming, if he's still present, but if he's not, that's cool.
Kella is here.
He's still here. Yeah.
If we can get a little bit of just drumming under it, that's perfect. But if anybody wants to share any transitions.
Jeffrey Vance.
Dr. Butterfly, you're still muted. Chanel Brown, Celestock.
Okay. Yes. I want to honor my Aunt Jean Foster. She, after my maternal grandmother died, she became the matriarch of that side of the family. So her passing is momentous. It definitely feels like the passing of an era.
My dad, Paul Robinson, passed away this semester, so I honor him in the family.
I want to lift up the name of Richard Sterling, a young man who was tragically killed in Oakland, California. I could use the family.
This is also an invitation to feel your feelings in this moment around them. You can also feel however you feel about that, because I know I'm feeling it. So if there are any other transitions that we would like to honor,
I'd also like to honor my Aunt Jane, who died this year, and it's also been a year since my father passed away.
Right, in terms of who passed away within the year, I'd like to honor my Aunt Pam, my Uncle David, my Uncle Mike, my uncle, my mom's cousin, Uncle Jack. There's like one or two more, but I can't remember. But any others before we transition to births?
Yeah, I'd like to honor two of my relatives, Rick Sampson and Beverly Dupuy. Beverly transitioned, she had COVID, and Rick, he actually transitioned 2 years after his wife did, just about a month ago, and they both had participated in raising me after my mother died when I was a child.
We can take a collective breath. The name of birth. I believe there's been at least one birth.
That's Amari.
That's Amari, and he was born to Samuel McFarlane and his partner. They could not be here because babies.
Oh, look at there.
He's a big old hunk of love.
I'm a baby.
Look at him. He's so cute.
Yes. And my nephew Adonis did turn one on the 23rd of April. I want to give thanks for that. And I can't remember who, but somebody in my cohort had a baby, or their wife had a baby. They didn't have a baby, you know. And we'll give thanks for that and honor to that as well.
I don't have it'll take me too much time to figure out how to get this picture from my phone on the Zoom. But Dr. Drake, Daniel Drake, her son turned one this year. So that's a major milestone for her and him. Yes.
Hey, young Kingston.
The Kingston, yes.
And I don't know. Oh, I was just gonna add for Taiba Hassan, who had a daughter about 6 months ago, Nova, who I got to meet for the first time on Mother's Day, just sending them a lot of love and talk about Black joy. She was someone who was an early supporter, and like she was a graduate of the Expressive Arts Therapy Program, but very active when she was a student in creating Black joy and excellence at CIIS.
Thank you, Rachel. Are there any other like births, new life, adoptions, anything that you want to bring in?
I want to name my nephew. His name is Sava. And okay. He's about 8 months or 7 months old.
Thanks.
He's a baby, so I bring him into the room.
Okay. So that's balance. We also want to talk transitions in the name of love. So if anybody got married, hitched up, coupled up, you know, shacking up, whatever you want to do, if you want to talk about it, name it, you can do so. Y'all all happy, single, already coupled up?
I think there's someone okay. With initials BB who got married.
I'm fortunate that to know that my amazing wife decided to say yes, and we got married on 7-Eleven. So thank you so much for this opportunity to share.
Yay! And many, 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 yes, many more happy, prosperous, joyful marriage. Lots of good feelings in it too. We also want to talk our professional and scholarly accomplishments. And even though I was ratchet and in my own stuff and missed his dissertation defense, I am going to honor Dr. Charles Chip McNeil, because that brother's bad, y'all. That brother's bad, y'all. Making my dimples come out. Now, Dr. Chip McNeil wrote and had the following academic contribution: Advancing Emancipatory Pedagogy, a Transdisciplinary Educational Framework for Healing and Liberation, AKA Black Folks Get Better. His inquiry addresses systemic inequities and systematic injustices in the public educational paradigm that disadvantage students of color and compromise their social and academic achievement. Dr. McNeil's research aims to distinguish a pedagogical framework meant to benefit African-American students by increasing connection to curricular content, motivation, and self-knowledge, resulting in improved academic and life achievement. The research aims to analyze educational literature through the theoretical lens of critical pedagogy and social-cultural learning theory. The implications of using select paradigmatic and theoretical frameworks in K-12 education research are also considered. A solution is proposed for restoring humanity to the educational paradigm by creating an original, transdisciplinary, emancipatory, conceptual educational framework that builds on existing theories of best practice, leveraging the intermingling of multiple theories, paradigms, and perspectives. A transdisciplinary approach promises to expose new ways of thinking, aid in accurately investigating the research question, and reveal aspects of the solution that might otherwise be obscured. A new macro term, emancipatory pedagogy, is proposed, with the term codified as a mega concept inclusive of various social justice principles and liberatory concepts. Chip has done more than just come, conquer, and graduate. He has served as a JEGNA for Black students in the Transformative Studies PhD program. He is a model for facilitation, listening, and speaking truth by articulating what we say so that we know, hear, and recognize the power of our words. Chip is a beacon of light and power, and it is my honor to honor the accomplishment of Dr. Chip McNeil.
Go boy.
Oh my God, Shamika. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
I manifested my chip, put on my red lacquer.
I saw you did, baby. You did.
My goon earrings. Oh, I brought all of me.
I am so grateful for this community, and I am so grateful for Adiba and all of you whose shoulder I stood on and who supported me and who created Black space so that I could do this work. I am so grateful to you. And I am just, all I've tried to do is just give back as the best I could to the community. And I'm just honored. Thank you so much for that recognition. I deeply appreciate it.
Oh, yep, we're proud of you.
Lord
thank have you mercy. Yes, we're so proud of you. Thank you so much for who you are and bringing your whole self to this work and to the BPP and the JEGNAship. And what is emancipatory pedagogy and taking it into the school systems? Ashe, yes. So we have another scholar, CIIS scholar, we want to recognize. Jen? You're muted.
Talking, no one can hear me. Just as we were listening to Shamika introduce Chip for his accomplishments and hitting that mark, and congratulations again, Dr. Chip. So excited for you and for all of us that get to cite your work in the future and bring it home and spread it through the world. And we are also then coming here to congratulate Shamika for defending her proposal and officially becoming a PhD candidate. Yay!
Woohoo! Yay! Yay, Shamika! Yay! Congratulations, girl!
Congratulations, girly! Oh, yes!
Yes. And if the assignment is correct, her dissertation uses darkened narrative inquiry and perhaps some darkened story work to examine Black women's experiences in doctoral programs at predominantly white institutions. Using sister circles to look at the experience of Black women who have been through groups like the BPP at CIIS Jagnaship Cohort and those who have not. So she's doing the work, y'all.
Congratulations, sis.
Where did you get those? I didn't send you.
She did her homework.
Clearly,
yes.
Moving forward and not being stuck, I'm supposed to actually say that I'm supposed to be starting my study, and I haven't done anything this semester. But the one thing I will do this semester that I'm not going to cry because I felt very stuck is I'm going to say I'm having a study. So if there's anybody in the Jagnaship cohort who has completed coursework, who is a Black woman who wants to talk to me about being in the sister circles, then just hit me up, and that's all I'm going to say. Thank you.
And I want to say a couple of things about Shamika as well. I have the honor and privilege to serve as her internal committee member for her dissertation. And it has been a joy to be on this journey with you from the very, very beginning. And I look forward to continue so that we can get that little bitty C off of that PhD. We're going to get rid of that C so you can be fully Dr. Shamika Smalling. I have forgotten to, because I've just been so busy doing so many things, to let you know that you have been invited to present on a panel at the International Conference for the Association of Black Psychologists. It's a Sankofa panel, and we're looking at the impact on Black students at predominantly white institutions. And so I am the moderator of said Mbongi. And I have extended an invitation to you to join us on that panel. So I will send you more details as soon as I'm finished grading and doing all of the other things that I'm doing. But you are on the panel.
I'll take 2 seconds because I wanted to just say, I want to thank y'all very much. I have not been okay. But I appreciate the space.
We love you, girl. Like, we love you, Shamika.
Saying that I haven't done anything, but I'm supposed to, like, I want to just take 2 seconds to brag on myself. I'm a student scholar at NCORDER, which means that I'm one of the doctoral students who was selected. I don't know how many they select to come, like free registration to be at the conference. I'm co-facilitating a 3-hour sister circle for Black women in higher ed. And I'm on the National Advisory Council for NCORE for the next 3 years. And I just like need y'all to reach out to me sometimes because I'm tired and this is hard work that we're doing, but I want to do, and I don't want to burn out. And that's,
we got you, Shamika. We got you.
Oh,
got you, girl.
Some blessings to you, baby.
Absolutely. Ashe, sis.
Ashe.
So we're going to move into the Dr. D. A couple of things that you wanted to speak on. So I'm going into the celebration of the graduates and the Jagnis, the highlight of this event.
Dr. D, you're muted.
Just wanting to take a moment to acknowledge one of our early BPP participants for the 2021-2022 cohort, and Angelina was also a part of the 2020 and 2021 cohort. Angelina Graham made her transition at a young age. She leaves a daughter and many beloved family members. She was not yet a student at CIIS, but she had a profound impact on many, many students here, and you all may not even know that. You probably saw her name come up on the screen whenever we would have our BPP workshops and our JEGNSHIP cohort sessions. Angelina was in the process of completing her dissertation. Her primary area of interest was Black women, womenism. She was a student at the Institute of Transpersonal Psychology, which is where I met her actually through the local Bay Area chapter. And when I was deciding where I wanted to go and do my graduate studies, Angelina recommended ITP. And so that's where I finished my master's degree. Glenn Hartilius was a mentor to Angelina. And I will share in another post, I'll probably put it up in the announcements, some of the words that he shared and to commemorate her contribution to the field of transpersonal psychology. She was a fierce, fierce scholar. And there is much work that she began that has been left for us to pick up and to continue. And so you will be hearing more about her work and different ways in which I hope through the various positions that I hold, serving on dissertation chairs and so forth, that we will be able to bring her work forward on womanism, spirituality, and transpersonal psychology. So just wanting to take a moment to honor and call her name, Angelina Graham, BPP JEGNSHIP Cohort 2020, 2021, 2022.
Ashe.
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 Dr. D, there were some other highlights that you wanted to share with the group?
Sure, I can do that now.
Okay.
So some of you may know that we have been busy working in the background, in the foreground, on the side ground, just covering a lot of ground to bring this vision into manifestation, the CIIS Center for Black and Indigenous Praxis. Let me move my little Zoom thing here out of the way. The two primary minds that have been at work here is the same two minds that brought you the BPP at CIIS is now bringing you the Center for Black and Indigenous Praxis. That would be myself and my beloved Rachel Bryant. The foundation for the Center for Black and Indigenous Praxis actually began all the way back in around 2015 with the MHSA ABCI cohort. That was our very first cohort. You just said her name. And why did it leave me? She just had a baby. Rachel, you just said her name. Taiba
Hassan.
Taiba was a participant in that very, very first cohort. And had it not been for Taiba, Natalie, and many others that we talked about when we had the alumni panel during the 28 Days of Blackness, you all would not be here today. Our second iteration was the MHSA ABCI cohort that following year. A couple of years later, that was followed by the Black Psychology as a Professional Gateway Project in 2018. And then that was followed by the Black Psychology Project or program in 2020, I believe. That was the 2020 variation. And none of these were done as an official part of CIIS. All of this work was done while I was a student and through the generosity, the creativity, the we gonna get this done-ness of Rachel, myself, and Freilani, and Yanni, with a lot of help from Sarah in advancement with that OSHPOD grant in 2018. And so as a parting gift, our former president, Dr. Judy Wexler, formally affirmed the Black Psychology Project as a part of CIIS. And so the BPP became officially a part of CIIS in September of last year. During that time, we had formed a beautiful reputation in the community. And through that powerful reputation, CIIS was able to acquire a $400,000 gift, which brought forward the Emerging Black Clinicians Fellowship Program. And we are continuing on in our second official year of the BPP. And next year, LaTronda will be stepping into the role of program manager, project manager for the BPP, we hope, because I am going to be stepping into a new role as the director for the Center for Black and Indigenous Praxis. So I'm just going to share real briefly. This is our draft mission and vision. So it's not, you know, it's not carved in stone yet. This is our working language. So I'm going to ask Rachel, if you can read this for me, I would appreciate it.
Oh, I just love how you put me on the spot, but we're ready. So the CIIS Center for Black and Indigenous Praxis serves as an epistemological axis, connecting multiple programs and services across CIIS. The CBIP serves students, faculty, staff, alumni, and community partners through culturally centered actualization of our 7 commitments. And the center will lead CIIS and thus the Academy, breaking ground here, beyond the anti-racist framework toward an optimal wellness and equity-driven paradigm. And I want to rest right there because we've just adopted an anti-racism framework to help us with the transformation of CIIS. And one of the things that I've learned from Adiba over the decade that we've been doing this is that we're really going toward optimal wellness, right? So anti-racism is like training wheels that should fall off, and we should be striving toward optimal wellness and equity-driven paradigms for everyone.
Okay.
And so it will serve as culturally centered engagement with CIIS's strategic priorities. It's rooted in Adiba's meta theory of Sankofa praxis, and it engages a cultural centered pedagogy of episteme, psychology, spiritness, and personhood. You go, Dr. D.
So just real in a snapshot, you can see that the Center for Black and Indigenous Praxis will serve as that hub. And our intention is to be able to touch all of the different aspects of CIIS, to touch the alumni services, to touch all of the dissertations. So we just, you know, bore witness to a new dissertation that's going to be available in our library. And so the intent is for the Center for Black and Indigenous Praxis, you can go there and you can find Dr. McNeil's dissertation years from now. And you won't have to wonder, did anybody ever write about that? We'll be able to help direct you to where those resources are. And these are just a few of the, these are our strategic priorities that we're going to be focused on, at least for the first 3 years of the Center for Black and Indigenous Praxis. So I'm going to not put Rachel on the spot again and just
do it.
You can do it?
If I know it. I mean, I don't want to read all of them. But I think there are some highlights here. So obviously, to illuminate the deep, rich history and ongoing contributions. So all you scholars on this call, all the scholars to come, all the scholars from before will be pulled together. This is definitely going to elevate our educational prominence and put CIIS on the map. To our knowledge, there's not another center like this. Obviously, students are at the center of this, so we're improving the student experience by confronting and countering academic inequity through expanded knowing, similar to what you've been doing in the Black Psychology Project. And we also want to forward a spirituality of action that confronts all forms of social oppression and creates sustainable, flourishing relationships based on our shared humanity. Some other highlights are like really wanting to connect with a community once we do our internal work to expand to our community, because we're in a community, we're not on an island at CIIS, and to connect students with partners that will enhance their learning experience and connect with their lived experience and social engagement. So I'll leave it there, Adiba.
Beautiful. So we're launching this fall, so stay tuned.
No, hit us up and get involved. That's even better.
All right. Thank you, Latronda. Back to you.
All right. Thank you. Thank you. So we're wanting to celebrate our Jagnees, those who have participated in our activities, our meetings. The Jagneeship cohort, leadership cohort, is a program or a leadership development group that we come together to exchange knowledge, to share in knowledge, and support one another's inquiries and studies and academic effort and progress. And so I just want to acknowledge all those who are here today. I'm trying to see if we can do a full screen share so I can see. I'm still having a hard time with,
gallery view.
Okay, right. Here we go. Yeah, there we go. I think that's everybody. So I'm going to call out Mary Hearns, Ayadele, and Natasha Holmes, and Cecilia. And Luna, who else we have here? We got Asabi, we got Jen. We have Kelly. So this year we've had 28 students in the BPP cohort. And we met on a regular basis every month. We met on Saturdays and attended the local chapter, ABCI, chapter meetings, and just been a great support to one another. So did you have anything that you wanted to add to that, Dr. D?
Yes, I do. I wanted to highlight the fact that the students come from all across CIIS. We have students who are in the undergraduate programs, in the master's in counseling psychology and other graduate programs, in doctoral programs, and they all come together as part of the BPP. We actually do an info session and outreach over the summer and an info session at the beginning of the fall semester. BPP Jagneeship cohort participants are asked to complete an application where they indicate why it is that they want to become a part of the BPP. What gifts do they bring to be of service to the BPP? And what contributions do they hope to make beyond the BPP back into community? The idea of Jagneeship, we've said that term a number of times tonight, and I don't know if everyone here is familiar with the term. It is a concept that was brought to me by Dr. Wade Nobles and Dr. Asa Hilliard from the Association of Black Psychologists. And in their brilliance and their Africanity, they were seeking a process by which African people can transfer knowledge from generation to generation that was not from a Western paradigm, not mentorship. And so they brought and drew from an Ethiopian Abyssinian concept of the term Jegna. And there are specific characteristics that one moves in who serves as a Jegna. They are tenacious, they are committed, they are dedicated, they are highly esteemed, they do great effort into their work. And they are co-learners, they are humble. They recognize that they too are on a path of knowledge. And so in a Jagneeship relationship, it is one where it is a co-learning experience. And so we've taken that model on to create the Jagneeship cohort, in part so that we can be in community with one another, and also so that we can sustain the BPP from generation to generation. So as I said in the little brief history that I gave, initially it was myself with support from Rachel, and we had a cohort of five. And over the years, we've been able to sustain that, primarily with me holding this position. And about 3 or 4 years ago, we implemented the assistant position for the JECNSHIP for the BPP, so that that person would then in time be able to step into the project manager role. And so now you see folks like Shamika, you see Jen Larson, you see Asabi, and many others. Mary is another example, who are very, very active in the JECNSHIP cohort. And so now I'm able to step over to the Center for Black and Indigenous Praxis. LaTronda is able to step forward into the BPP manager position. And she has a whole a group of people who have been working with her as part of the JECNSHIP cohort, so that it can replicate, it can sustain itself, and it can grow. And so we have alumni that have joined us. Butterfly, Dr. Butterfly Williams, is an alumni of the Black Psychology as a Professional Gateway Project. He is a graduate of Saybrook University, and we would not have him with us had it not been for our community outreach. So the BPP has so much potential left to be fully flourished. We're just getting started. Even though we've got deep roots, we still have a lot of flourishing yet to come. And so I'm really, really excited and looking forward to see this. It just does my heart so good, because Rachel knows how hard she and I, we still work. But we remember when it was just the two of us just getting it done. And now, like, I get an agenda. LaTronda, Asabi, and Jen, they just tell me, and Shamika, they just say, hey, Dr. D, this is the agenda. Wear white. This is what you're doing. And I'm like, good. So thank you for my BPP family. Thank you for my BPP cohort. I love and appreciate each and every one of you.
I do want to just add a little bit more information about the meeting of JECNSHIP and why it is so critical for us to continue to cultivate more leaders in this program. Because to be a JECNSHIP, there are special people who have been tested in struggle or battle. They have demonstrated extraordinary and unusual fearlessness. They have shown demonstration of courage in protecting his or her people, land, and culture, because we're also considered culture keepers. All these BPP workshops and activities and the 28 Days of Blackness is all part of this JECNSHIP leadership program. And they are shown diligence and dedication to our people, and as well as produce high quality work. So whatever it is that we're doing is going to be exceptional. And one of our themes also, I think last year, was Black excellence. So we're just making sure that we're continuing the work and completing what has been incomplete from our ancestors, and making sure that we're moving forward with that effort.
So LaTronda, is it okay now for us to, for me to present my gifts to the four of you?
You're muted, LaTronda.
You're so muted.
Yes, thank you. And then we'll be opening the floor for last words and comments from everyone else. And of course, the JECNSHIPs, the JECNSHIPs, if you have anything that you want to add or want to say or speak on, certainly this will be an opportunity for you to do so. And then Damali will close us out.
So to help me do this quicker, LaTronda, I think I'm almost have everybody. If you can spotlight, I just did you. I need Jen. I need to spotlight you and Jen. I've got Asabi. And I need to spotlight myself. I don't know why they have the person with not the best vision doing the spotlighting, but here we are. All right. So Asabi is the bearer of gifts. I was in the Bay Area this weekend in my core faculty in the School of Undergraduate hat. And I got to come on campus for the first time since 2019 and actually teach in a classroom, room 210. I hadn't been in room 210 since we did into psychotherapy back in 2016. And it was wonderful. So I was in the Bay Area over the weekend teaching an in-person intensive class, and it was lovely. And I was able to bring my gifts, drop them off with Rachel. Asabi went by her place today and picked them up. I have one here because I'm going to be seeing Shamika in Portland at the end of the month for Encore. And so Asabi, if you can hold up your gift. It's the one with the mask. There you go. So yes. So Asabi, I want to say to you, thank you, thank you, thank you. I have known you longer than anybody that's in this space. I met you almost right as soon as I moved to Oakland in 1997, and I have watched you bring up two beautiful twins and nurture yourself and nurture the community. And we would talk and talk, and you were a part of my circle when I was saying, oh, I really want to go back to school and finish my bachelor's degree. And you were cheering me on saying, yeah, you can do it. You can do it. So you watched me finish my bachelor's degree. You watched me finish my master's degree. You watched me finish my doctorate degree. And you, and all along, you're like, I'm going to come too. I'm going to come too. And here you are. You have been in my classes now as one of my students. And you also are here with the BPP. You make me smell good and make my skin look good with your home, with my shea butter that you be hooking a sister up. And I just love you. I just love you and appreciate you. And so that backpack was purchased. I bought it from a sister. You may remember her, Nubia I, Lisa Marie. She lives in Ghana, in Accra. And I purchased that from her, and she shipped it to me from Accra. And so if you open it up, you'll see there's some other little gifts inside. There's a little gift in the front pocket. And then if you open up the flap of the backpack, there's some more gifts inside. So while she does that and unfolds all of her gifts, I have this beautiful bag. So I told you I'm the one who has the only one who I'm going to see in Portland, so everybody know whose bag this is. Yes, Shamika, this is your bag.
I love it. Look at it. It's beautiful.
Basically, since you've been on the road, we don't ever know where Shamika is. She's in a plane.
Oh my God, you don't even understand. That's gonna look at all my outfits in Portland.
All your stuff can fit in here. So it's a beautiful overnight bag. Also purchased from my sister friend in Accra, Ghana. And inside it's really nice. It's lined, it has some pockets. It'll hold a whole bunch of stuff. And inside there is, and all of you have the same thing inside of your bags, except for Shamika has a little something extra. So there's this beautiful African coloring book that's inside. So, oops, stuff is falling out. Hold on. So there's this really beautiful African coloring book. So when you're on the go and you need to take some self-care time, you can get your pencils out and do that. And there is also, everyone, you know how much I love Paul Lewin, the artist. So each of you have a postcard from Paul Lewin. And this one I've had for many, many years. And it is Nana from Jamaica, Nana and the Pumpkin Eaters. And so this is what is inside of your bag, Shamika. And then on
I love it. So Dr. D, I just want to be respectful of people's time. Some folks have already informed me that they have to log off at 6:00. And we're almost there. It's like 5:57. did. And I wanted to make sure we do our closing prayer before logging off.
So let me show. So if you can hold up Jen's, everybody has the same thing on the inside. So if you can hold up Jen's bag so she can see it. So Jen, yours has a carving of Africa on the flap. And then you can hold up Latronda's.
That is gorgeous. Those bags are gorgeous.
And Latronda, you have a bag like Shamika.
I love it. That's going with me everywhere I go.
Yeah,
it's gonna have books and folders and everything else. It's beautiful. It's beautiful.
And then one last thing I'll share, and then I'll be quiet. Inside each of them is a hand carved candlestick from Kenya. So you have one of those.
Oh my!
And then the last thing I'll say is, Latronda, I special ordered a stool, an Asante stool for you. And it is being carved. Didn't make it for tonight, but it is being carved. And when I see you at our DDEI retreat, hopefully I will have it in hand. I will be able to hand you the stool as the new BPP program project manager.
Wow, I'm at a loss for words. I don't even know what to say. That's so beautiful. I'm so grateful. I'm grateful for you, Dr. D. I'm grateful for you all, Asabi and Jen and Shamika and Rachel and Damali and Deanna and Kamiko. I just met you today, girl, but I'm grateful for you and Kaylee and Chip. Oh my God, so inspiring your work. And Dr. Butterfly, and we have Brock in the house. He's our president. Okay, a CIIS, the new president. So exciting. We got Auntie in the house. We know she's gonna always have our back. We don't got to worry about nothing. So thank you. Thank you all so much, and I love you.
And I'm just jumping in here to ask, is there enough time for Kamiko to sing her last song? Or maybe not?
I'm here. Because you know how we hang out in the parking lot anyway.
Okay, right. And we have to close. Somehow we got to close this. But, we have to close.
Let's do it in this order. Let's have Damali do our closing. And then as people leave the room, we can have her do the song.
Kamiko. Perfect. Thank you.
Okay.
All right. Thank y'all. So I want to just share this closing prayer. Mother, Father, Spirit, the universe in all her forms, I close this time together in gratitude. Gratitude for every student, speaker, and presenter. Gratitude for every alum who shines a light in the world. Gratitude for every staff member and faculty member. Gratitude for all our guests. Gratitude for the BPP family who brought this closing ceremony to life. Gratitude for this space, the optimal space where we flow and flourish, this loving space where we always belong, where we can be our full and complete selves and all our brilliance. I speak this word of prayer and gratitude in divine recognition of this moment together. I give thanks, and I am filled with thanksgiving, filled with this word, the spirit that honors our ancestors, the generations who came before us, the generations who opened the way. We are our ancestors' wildest dreams. I am that I am. I am an answer to a prayer, Ashe, children of freedom seekers, children of dream weavers, children of infinite possibilities. I give thanks for those who came before us, family, chosen family, neighbors, beloved community, friends. I give thanks for them. I give thanks because we are dreams realized. We are an answer to a prayer. We are generations of gratitude made form. Thank you for this academic year and this closing ceremony. I close this time together now saying amen, ashe, and so it is.
And so it is.
Ashe.
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 Beautiful.
So, Tomiko had to go.
Yes.
But we still have Kayla here, and he can drum for us. He can drum us out.
Yes.
So we. So take it away, Kayla. Well, thank you all for coming. This is beautiful. Do we have any Jagnis that want to speak now? Have any last words or, you know, any comments that you want to part with? The floor is open for that.
I feel so much better. Thank y'all.
Thank you, Shamika.
In the spirit, I walk in the light, I walk in the darkest hours of night, and I call on my ancestors from my left and my right to walk with me, to walk with me. I walk in the spirit, I walk in the light, I walk with the knowledge that we'll be all right, and we call on our ancestors who are left and the right. In the light, you walk with your neighbor to fight the good fight, and we call on our ancestors to our left and our right to walk with us, to walk with us. Yes, we call on our ancestors to our left and our right to walk with us, to walk with children and the right to survive, and we call on our ancestors to our left and our right to walk with us, to walk with us. We walk in the spirit, we walk in the light, we walk in the knowledge that we gon' be all right. Yes, we call on our ancestors to our left and our right to walk with us, to walk with us. We call on our ancestors to our left and our right to walk with us, to walk with us. We call on our ancestors to our left and our right to walk with us. Ashe.
Ashe. Ashe. Ashe.
Thank you for your music, brother. Thank you for your music.